So first, working from this, a nice photograph that I've got of a common yellowthroat in this case, which is a species of warbler. In this case, I'm just going to eyeball blowing that up to a larger size on my 9x12 piece of canvas board. On a larger, more complex painting involving an animal, I would generally do a lot of measuring and make sure I've got the proportions right, but I think I can just, in this case, because it's a single bird, the background's going to be very simple, I think I can just do this by eye and get it about the way I want it. We'll see how it comes out. And it may be hard for you to see that sketch. I'm just looking back and forth between the photograph and the canvas by constantly shifting my eyes back and forth. It will hopefully let me see any corrections I need before I get way off. The perspective's a little bit tricky on something like this bird because there's a lot of foreshortening involved, because the front of the bird is coming closer to you than the back part of the bird. So the head, the front's going to look larger in proportion than if it were a straight side view. So you can't look at it in terms of, that doesn't look like the size of bird's head ought to be, or the size of their legs ought to be, because it'll fool you. The perspective will make you, if you try to do by what you think it should be, the perspective's going to get off. So I'm just going to sketch it on here, trying to sketch it just the way it is rather than the way I think it ought to be, and then we'll see from there. The twig it's on, I'm going to change the twig around a little, make it a twig that kind of forks just for a little more interest. I've got the basic photograph of the bird in the way that I like, so I can kind of make up some of what the rest that's around it to frame it in a little bit better. So let's see how this is looking here. This yellow throat's got a black mask across the face. I want to make sure I've got those distinctive marks. This is not a painting for a field guide, so I'm not so much concerned with every little detail that you would if you were doing an illustration for a field guide or something like that, like Roger Torrey Peterson might do. This is about the beauty of the bird and capturing the essence of it, so I'm not looking for every tiny detail. Let's see, just kind of get some higher on the head yet. Make sure I've got that head plenty big. Again, because of that foreshortening that's happening. I think I've got that about right. A little closer here. Hopefully you can see that pretty well. And then we'll start in with the painting. Few little adjustments here in my sketch. Proportions a bit better. Alright, I've got my palette, my basic palette that I always use the same. Two yellows, cadmium yellow light, cadmium yellow medium, cadmium red medium, magenta, ultramarine blue, phthalo cyanon or phthalo blue, and black. Oh, I need my white yet. The brightest, almost pure white areas on the bird. I generally start with the brightest and work darker. It seems like that's, while I don't think about it, it just seems to be what I usually do. So I guess that would be my advice. Start bright and go darker. But every artist will give you different advice on that kind of a thing. It doesn't really matter, whatever works for you. I'm going to get a little bit done here, and then I'm going to come back after I've got some more finished so you can see how it's looking, because you certainly don't want to watch every minute of this. Some bright on the toes, start establishing some of that. hold my brush right up next to the photo to sometimes to check to make sure I'm getting my colors about the way I want them. So we've got some bright yellow underneath on the throat, which is where the bird gets its name. And again, because this is not a technical illustration, I want it to have a painterly quality. I'm putting my paint on fairly thick. Doesn't allow it to be quite as sharp and accurate, but it'll give a nice quality of the painting, not even attempting to look photographic in the end. Now this is kind of an interesting area as I work on the shadowing underneath the breast of the bird. It gives it that nice rounded look. So I'm mixing up a color that's really it's got just about all my colors, no black, but it's got a little bit of all the, well, at least the ultramarine blue, the two reds, the yellow. And essentially I had to hold my brush up against the next to the photo to figure out, because it's such a strange color underneath there that you really can't just think about it, mix it up. You just have to mix some colors, hold it up, see whether it needs to be redder, bluer, yellower, and go from there to get that color mix. I think I've got it pretty good now. Now as we come up around, keep mixing. I'm trying to get some of that color over along the side now. Up in here, which is kind of going to a light tan yellow color. Not as much yellow as underneath the chin, but and yet it's sunlit, so it's getting more into this kind of a range, I think. And see how I'm dragging my brush through the existing? This is Alkyd oil paint. So it's going to stay wet for a while. I'm working wet on wet, and I'm able to kind of drag my what's on the brush now into and out of what's on from before to get that soft. And if I do it with kind of a briskness and letting some brush strokes show, it gives sort of that feel of it being little tiny soft feathers on the underside of that bird. And that's what we want to have. We want to have that soft, fluffy feel to it. And that's what dragging the color through like that gives us. Start getting into some of the really cool stuff. And that's when you start putting the really dark, the black or very nearly black areas in. It will all of a sudden bring definition to things and make what seems a little bit diffuse and hard to figure out really come alive. You can see I did start doing that around the feet a little bit, but now watch, I'm going to put those dark shadows underneath the wings, the wing, underneath the tail, just working around where I already have my color down. Next thing I'm going to go to after I get some more on the legs here, and these legs will have to be thinned down, but see I can thin the legs down when I put the dark background around them. That will basically serve to thin the legs down to whatever they should be. So I'm not going to worry about the fact that they look kind of thick and unbird-like now. We'll take care of that with the background. But I want to get these areas in first that aren't real dark and black, because That mask on the yellow throat's face is almost pure black. So I'm going to mix just a little bit of my blue and red in with it. So I'm not painting with quite pure black, but it's very nearly a pure black on that face mask. And so let's get that in. I'm not even going to worry about the eye. I'll define the eye with lighter color after I get. I'm just going to paint right through that and doing the black of the mask. Thank you. back edge of the mask, it kind of gets a little bit softer with the other feathering of the face. So I'm going to do a little bit of that dragging in with the colors around it just to soften that up a bit back end, even though where it's up against the white, it's a very sharp line. Now I'm going to start doing background around it. For that I'm going to mix up, I don't want it quite as green as it is there. A little bit of a greenishness I guess is alright, but I'm going to have a little more red in with it too, because I don't want it to be overwhelmingly so green. But quite dark. Not black, but dark. So that it really sets off the lighter colored bird. And I'm working right up to the bird. And this is where I use the trick of not mixing my paint real well on the palette, so I've got kind of some variation in the colors behind the bird, because I want it to be. Remember, we're suggesting this bird is sitting, it's kind of sitting on a branch, maybe the edge of a woodlot. There's going to be all kinds of foliage and things like that actually behind the bird, so kind of a jumbly look in the background is fine. That's what I want. Now down underneath here though, I want to make sure I don't have it too dark, because I want the dark of that tail to show up as darker against the background. That greener look back there, which means I want to carry it through a little bit over here so that it makes sense visually. Then we can go back to the deeper, richer background over on this side.